states have chosen not to listen to the advice of medical experts. There are even politicians in Illinois who ignore science and instead are playing to a small minority who protests at our state capitol. Most of the states with the largest economies have chosen to listen to the science and analyze the data and act according to what will restart jobs and businesses safely. I can say with confidence that here in Illinois, we've committed to operating with a focus on public health and transparent, measurable benchmarks to move to each new phase. For those interested in seeing the data and the metrics, they're updated each afternoon and posted online at dph.illinois.gov/restore. Joining us today are two experts in infectious disease control to provide their perspectives. Dr. Richard Novak, head of the Division of Infectious Diseases at the University of Illinois Health System, and Dr. Emily Landon, the Executive Medical Director for Infection Prevention and Control at University of Chicago Medicine, who first joined us in March and inspired so many Illinoisans to help keep each other safe. These two doctors have graciously offered their time to update you on the battle against COVID-19, which is still very much alive in the halls of our hospitals and among the population at large. Before I turn the mic over to them, I want to say that I know there are some of our fellow Illinoisans who feel that their lives didn't change much between phase one and phase two, and we're all itching to move ahead. So why can't we just do it now? Well, there's no doubt this is hard. But public health means that each of us is working to protect all of us. It's about our collective impact on each other. And because many Illinoisans are engaged with the reopenings that have occurred in phase two, it's critical that we observe the full 28-day measurement period before moving forward to phase three. The good news is that we're just 10 days from that point. And as of now, all four regions of Illinois are on track and moving forward into phase three before the end of May. As residents, businesses, and employees gear up for phase three, we will be providing specific safety and mitigation guidelines for workplaces and activities that are reopening. These guidelines have been in development with business owners, employee representatives, and industry associations, including many women and minority-owned operations. And I look forward to sharing more information about that in the coming days.